we begin with new developments on the investigation into remains found in a freezer inside of a Lewiston storage locker back in October. Maine State Police said this afternoon the remains have been identified as Kitty Wardwell, who disappeared nearly 30 years ago. News 8's Jim Keithley is live tonight in Lewiston with more on tonight's top story. Jim.
Well, Tracy, for Kitty Wardwell's family, this news doesn't come as a big surprise. I just got off the phone with her brother. He lives in Bucksport. He believes that his sister's former boyfriend, Frank Julian, got away with murder. Now, it was inside this 10-foot by 10-foot storage unit where Julian's family discovered the human remains in an unplugged freezer 6 weeks ago, a few weeks after Julian died at the age of 80. They were here cleaning out his belongings. Now, Julian and Kitty Wardwell dated back in the 80s. She disappeared 28 years ago. Police have ruled her death a homicide. There are still, however, many unanswered questions. Had the body been in the freezer since Julian first rented this storage unit 19 years ago? And where was her body for the first 9 years after she disappeared? That's why police still won't release the cause of death. DNA tests performed at a lab in Pennsylvania confirmed the identity just yesterday. Authorities say it took so long because her body was badly decomposed. And state police say this case is far from closed.
We suspect that the body has been in the freezer, in the storage unit, for obviously probably the majority of the time that he rented that storage locker, but we're not sure, because we've got to know when that freezer entered there and where her remains were prior to going into Lewiston. And those are all good questions that we have that we don't have answers to, and we will now start that phase of the investigation to get those answers.
All right, and Kitty Wardwell's brother told me, quote, "We are relieved as a family. We finally have some kind of closure here." He also told me that now he has to plan a funeral nearly three decades after his sister went missing. We're live in Lewiston. Jim Keithley, News 8.